Okay, so for today's video, we are going to learn about circles. So there are two equations of a circle. So the first one is standard equation. So standard equation, the formula is x minus h square plus y minus k square equals to r square. And the other equation is general equation. So general equation is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals to 0. So from these two equation, we can extract center. Okay, ambil demi center. So the center is HK for standard equation. For general equation, the center is negative G. Okay, from here, and negative F from here. Okay, then for radius, radius for standard equation is here R. So we have R square from this standard equation. So just second, we'll get the radius. For general equation, the radius is set g square plus f square minus c. So let's look at the first example. First example, find center and radius of the circle. X square plus y square equals to 117 minus 4y. So this is general equation because we have x square, y square and also y. Okay, kalau standard equation, kita hanya ada x square dan y square. So, kalau untuk, ini untuk standard equation kan? Kalau untuk general equation, dia ada x square, dia ada x, dia ada y square, dia ada y. So this one adalah general equation because we have y square and y. Okay, so kita pilih dulu. This one adalah general equation. Okay, so saya akan rearrange dulu equation kita. So x square plus y square plus 4y minus 117 equals to 0. Okay, so supaya dia ada dalam bentuk general equation kita ni lah. Supaya ada dalam bentuk ini. Okay, so then kita akan compare. Compare with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals to 0. So from here, saya tukarkan sekejap. We'll get 2g equals to 0. Okay, kenapa 0? Sebab kita tak ada x, coefficient x kat sini. So 2g equals to 0. So therefore we'll get g equals to 0. Then 2f equals to 4. Therefore, we'll get f equals to negative 2. C equals to negative 117. So, center untuk general equation adalah negative g, negative f. So, what is the center? 0, negative, negative 2. Dan kita akan dapat center dia adalah 0, 2. That is the center. Dan sekarang kita nak tengok dia punya radius. Formula radius for general equation adalah set g square plus f square minus c. Okay, aku dah tersengat-sengat dah tu. Okay, so what is the value of g? 0 square plus negative 2 square minus negative 117. Okay, so kita pun tekan kalkulator. Okay, so set. So, negative 2 square. So, dapat 4. Plus 117. So, kita dapat 121. So, set 121. Kita akan dapat 11. So, radius is 11. So, dapatlah. Center 0, 2. Radius 11. Okay, now. Moving to question example 2, sorry, example 2. Express 3x square plus 3y square plus 12x minus 6y plus 3 equals to 0 into standard form. Okay, so this one is general, then kita nak tukar kepada standard. Okay, hence find the center and radius of the circle. So this one adalah general. Kita nak tukar kepada standard. Okay, so daripada general ke standard kita nak buat apa? Daripada general ke standard kita akan CTS kan. Okay, so jom kita tengok macam mana CTS kan. 3x squared plus 3y squared plus 12x minus 6y plus 3 equals to 0. Tapi before kita CTS, kita kena tengok depan x squared, depan y squared mesti coefficient dia 1. So what we need to do now adalah kita factorize 3. So x squared plus y squared plus 4x minus 2y plus 1 equals to 0. Factorize dulu. Sebab apa? Sebab bila kita nak buat CTS, coefficient of x square and y square must be 1. Okay. Jadi x square plus y square plus 4x minus 2y plus 1 equals to 0. So, kita akan susun ikut term. Plus y square minus 2y plus 1 equals to 0. Okay, so kita akan CTS kan this one. Okay, alamak, sekejap. Nampak sikit. And CTS yang ini. Okay. So, CTS yang hijau dulu. X. Sorry. X plus 2 square minus 2 square. Then the other one. Y minus 1 square minus negative. This one untuk yang hijau. Okay. This one adalah untuk yang merah. CTS yang merah. Okay. Don't forget we have one tu. Dekat belakang tu. Ha, so plus 1 equals to 0. Okay. So x plus 2 square minus 4 plus. Jangan pergi kembang balik pula. Kita memang nak CTS kan. So minus 1 plus 1 equals to 0. So coefficient kita bawa ke right hand side. Sebab bila kita nak tukar kepada standard form, so tengok balik pada standard form. Bila kita nak tukar kepada standard form, constant kita letak dekat right hand side. Okay. So x plus 2 square plus y minus 1 square equals to 4. Okay. So dah jadilah dalam bentuk standard form. Then from here kita boleh cari dengan standard apa tu? Center dan radius. Comparekan dengan x minus h square plus y minus k square equals to r square. So from here we get h equals to negative 2, k equals to 1, r square equals to 4, then r equals to 2. Okay, so what is the center? Center for standard equation is hk. So negative 2, 1. Then radius is r, so 2. So dah siap lah. Then for example 1 and example 2.
Okay, question 10. Find the general equation of each of the circle that satisfy the stated condition. So the first one is the circle is tangent to x axis, radius of length 4 unit and x coordinate is 3. So kita tandakan dua apa-apa yang kita ada. First kali, okay, tangent to x axis. Tangent to x axis. So bila dia kata tangent to x axis, maksudnya kita punya circle akan touch x axis. Okay, so saya cuba lukis. Okay, kita tukar warna sekejap. Kita lukis tangent to x axis. So ke sini lah, macam tu. Okay. Then what else we have? Radius of length 4. So kita tandakan dulu. So this is our center. Then from center to here, this is the radius. And this one is also the radius. Okay. So radius equals to 4. Radius equals to 4. Then x coordinate is 3. X coordinate of center is 3. So that means bila kita nak buat center dia, okay, saya zoomkan sikit. Kita buat center dia, dia akan jadi 3 something. Okay. Lepas tu, bila kita tengok dekat sini, what is the value of y ordinate dekat sini? Okay, bila kita tengok, y adalah jarak kan daripada sini ke sini kan? So, then kita tahu jarak daripada sini ke sini, dia punya jarak dia adalah 4 sebab dia sama dengan radius kan. Okay, so dekat sini jarak dia adalah 4. That means y coordinate kita kat sini pun adalah 4. So we have center. Center 3, 4. And we also have the radius 4. So if we have radius and center, kita nak cari equation circle, kita boleh terus masukkan dalam standard equation. Okay, so kita akan substitute, use formula standard equation. This one adalah standard equation, eh, standard equation. So masukkanlah h dan k dan r. Okay, dan kita tahu from center, this one adalah hk, this one kita boleh sub dalam r. So x minus 3 square plus y minus k square, sorry, k 4 square equals to r square, 4 square. Tapi soalan nak general, we have standard, so what we need to do, kita expand. Okay, sebab ni standard, kita nak general, so kita akan expand. So expand x square minus 6x plus 9 plus y square minus 8y plus 16 minus 16. Ni saya bawa 4 square ke sebelah sana, equals to 0. Okay, so selesaikan, simplify whatsoever, semua-semua-semua, kita akan dapat x square plus y square minus 6x, oh sorry, this one is 8y, eh, minus 8y, so plus 9 equals to 0. Okay, ha, so macam tu je lah. Kita ada radius, kita ada center, masukkan dalam standard. So kalau soalan nak general, just expand sahaja. Okay, tapi perasan tak soalan ni dia ada bagi tahu tak kita nak dekat above x axis ke below x axis? Dia tak bagi tahu kan. So maksudnya we will have two answer here. Okay, macam mana dapat two answer? Kita masih lagi ada radius 4 with a circle, dan dia masih lagi tangent to x axis. Tapi sekarang ni kita akan buat lagi satu option. Saya ingat tu. Okay, tapi dia below x axis. Ni x tadi, ha, ni above x axis. Sebab apa kita kena buat dua option? Sebab soalan tak bagi tahu dia nak above x axis ke below x axis. Dia just bagi tahu touch sahaja. So kita kena buat dua-dua option, above x axis dan below x axis. So untuk soalan ini, center masih lagi sama ke? Center masih lagi sama ke? Okay, untuk x ordinate masih lagi sama 3. Tapi untuk y ordinate, okay, so oleh sebab kita dah turun ke bawah, di sana, eh, dari sini ke sini, sorry, jarak dia masih lagi 4. Ini saya tak payah buat kat sini lah. Kejap. Kejap. Okay, kita boleh buat radius kan? Sebab dia radius. So, maksudnya dari sini ke sini pun r equals to 4 lah. R equals to 4. So, adakah center dia masih lagi sama? Tak. Center dia sekarang akan jadi 3 negative 4. Okay. So, center 3 negative 4. Radius kita dapat 4. Okay, so untuk yang ini pula, equation dia masih lagi sama, x minus 3 square, okay, plus y minus negative 4 square equals to 4 square. Kita hanya ubah pada center sahajalah. Substitute dalam standard, kita hanya ubah pada center. So bila kita expand, kita akan dapat x square plus y square minus 6x plus 8y plus 9 equals to 0. Okay, so two option, below x axis dan juga above x axis. Okay, done for question 10a. Now moving to question 10b. Okay, so we have a circle tangent to both axes. So maksudnya dia akan touch x axis, y axis. Radius of 6 unit and the center is in the third quadrant. Okay, so center, so a circle, dia kata touch x, apa, tangent to both axes kan. Okay, jom kita buat. Okay, tu dia dah terlari sikit. Okay, kita adjust sikit. Okay, then the tangent to x axis juga. Okay, sekejap. Okay, ni pun kita boleh ubah, kita ubahlah sikit. Sebab kita nak bagi tulisan dia sama kan. Eh, nak bagi lukisan dia betul-betul sama. Lukisan yang tepat. Okay. So, Y, X. Dan kenapa saya buat kat kuadran ketiga? Sebab dia kata center is in third quadrant. So, that means center kita dekat sini. So, dia beritahu apa lagi? Radius. Radius equals to 6. So, maksudnya, from here to here, R equals to 6. So, from here to here pun sama juga. R equals to 6. So, dah dapat center belum? Center akan jadi negative 6. Negative 6. So, untuk soalan ni pun sama. We have radius R. We have center. Eh, sorry. Radius R pula. Radius 6. And we have center. Negative 6. Negative 6. So, nak buat apa kalau kita dah ada radius dan center? Masukkan dalam standard equation. Okay. So, this one akan jadi HK. This one akan jadi R. So, X minus H square plus Y minus K square plus tu R square. 6 square. Tambah je lah. Square plus Y plus 6 square equals to 36. Tapi sebab kita nak jadikan dia dalam bentuk general, kita kena expand. So, X square plus Y square plus 12X plus 12Y plus 36 equals to 0. Okay. So, this one adalah standard. Okay. This one adalah general. So, nak buat apa daripada standard ke general? Kita expand. Okay, so done for question number 10. Moving to question 11, find the equation of a circle that is passing through point 1, 2, negative 1, 2 and 0, negative 1. Hence, determine its center. So, from this question, kita nak cari equation circle. Then, this circle passing through 3 points. So, bila dia cakap passing through 3 points, maksudnya point itu ada pada atas circle kita betul-betul. So, contohnya dekat sini lah. Negative 1, 2. 0, negative 1. 0, negative 1. And 1, 2 dekat sini lah kot. Haa, sini. 1, 2. Haa, so bila circle kita passing through 3 points. Okay, tengok dalam box merah tu. Apa yang kita akan buat adalah kita akan substitute all the 3 points into general equation. Okay, sub dalam general equation. Then, kita akan sub simultaneous equation itu. Okay, so saya tulis kat sini. Ini kita sub into general equation. So, we'll start with the first point lah. Okay, so nanti saya ambil point 1, 2. So, substitute 1, 2 into general equation. Okay, general equation. So, what is our general equation? This is our general equation. Okay. So, masukkan je lah. 1 square plus 2 square plus 2g1 plus 2f2 plus c equals to 0. So, from here, rearrange, we got c equals to negative 5 minus 2g minus 4f. First equation. Okay, the next one. Substitute negative 1, 2 into general equation. So, negative 1 square plus 2 square plus 2g negative 1 plus 2f2 plus c equals to 0. So, c equals to negative 5 plus 2g minus 4f. So, second equation. Then, kita akan sub the last point. Substitute 0, negative 1 into GE. So, 0 square plus negative 1 square plus 2G0 plus 2F negative 1 plus C equals to 0. So, from here, we'll get C equals to 2F minus 1. Okay, so sekarang dah boleh terus sub lah simultaneous equation kita. Okay, solve simultaneous equation. so lepas kita dah dapat nilai G, F dan C, kita akan substitute balik. Substitute G, F and C into our general equation. Therefore, we'll get X square plus Y square plus 2GX plus 2FY plus C equals to 0. So, simplify. Then, kita akan dapat X square plus Y square minus 4 over 3y minus 7 over 3 equals to 0. So, this is our general equation. Terus ambillah center adalah negative g negative f. So, what is our g? So, jadi 0. So, negative negative. So, 2 over 3. And dah siap. Okay, moving to question 11. Find the equation of the circle passing through 3, 2 with diameter y minus 3x plus 7 equals to 0. So, kalau kita tengok pada soalan ni, we have this 2 point, 3, 2. So, 1, maybe somewhere here. 3, 2, maybe somewhere here. And we have equation y minus 3x plus 7 equals to 0. Y minus 3x plus 7 equals to 0. Okay, so apa yang kita akan buat? First kali, substitute 2 point into general equation. So, substitute 1 into general equation. So, general equation yang mana? Yang x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals to 0. Okay, so, masuklah. Square plus 1 square plus 2g1 plus 2F1 plus C equals to 0. So, C equals to negative 2G. Negative 2G minus 2F minus 2 equals, ni equation 1. Then, substitute the second one, 3, 2 into GE, general equation, 3 square plus 2 square plus 2G3. Plus 2F2 plus C equals to 0. So, from here we get C equals to negative 6G minus 4F minus 13. Okay. Then, kita tengok step kedua, seterusnya step B tu. Substitute center negative G negative F into AX plus BY plus C equals to 0. So, kita akan substitute negative G negative F into y minus 3x plus 7 equals to 0. So, this one will be x. This one will be substituted into y. So, we'll get negative f minus 3 negative g plus 7 equals to 0. So, f kita akan dapat 3g plus 7. Okay, so ini adalah equation ketiga. So now kita akan substitute, kita akan solve simultaneously. Okay, solve simultaneous equation. Bila kita dah dapat semua nilai G, F dan C, kita akan substitute ke dalam kita punya general equation. So, substitute G, F, C into general equation. Therefore, equation of circle is X square plus Y square plus 2, negative 2, X plus 2 negative 1 over 2y plus c equals to 0. C equals to 4 plus 4 equals to 0. Therefore, we'll get x square plus y square minus 5x minus y plus 4 equals to 0. Then, 13, a circle which lies in the first quadrant touches the x-axis, y-axis, and the straight line 4x minus 3y minus 30 equals to 0. Find the equation of the circle. So, from this question, okay, sebelum kita tengok yang box merah tu, kita cuba lukis dia. Okay, so first x, first quadrant touch x-axis, y-axis, lebih kurang macam soalan yang kita dah buat tadi. Okay, so touch y-axis, touch x-axis. Okay, so kalau lari tu kita ubahlah sikit, kejar di balik. Okay, then y, x, and another one, dia touch 4x minus 3y minus 30 equals to 0. Okay, so apa lagi yang kita ada? Okay, lupa nak tulis dia punya equation. 4x minus 3y minus 30. Okay, daripada kita punya diagram ni, we will have dia punya radius. Kita boleh senang untuk cari radius. So, saya tandakan dengan warna lain lah. Macam warna green. Okay, so this one is the radius. So, this one is also the radius. So, adakah kita tahu the value of the radius? No, we don't know yet what is the radius. Tapi, kita akan assume kita ada radius lah. So, our center. Sini lah. Okay. Our center is RR. Okay, so maksudnya dekat sini, kalau kita dapat tahu dia punya radius, kita dah boleh cari dah. Okay, then kita tengok dekat sini, kita juga ada satu tangent line. Macam mana kita boleh kata dia adalah tangent line? Sebab dia kata touch straight line itu. So, bila dia touch je, dia akan jadi tangent. Okay, kalau tengok kepada step B, kita boleh cari R by using shortest distance formula. Kenapa boleh cari shortest distance? So, tengok yang dekat sini, dekat sini pun, dia akan jadi R. Okay, sekejap. Kita tukar sekejap. Okay, dekat sini pun dia boleh jadi R. Okay, dengan syarat dekat sini boleh jadi, kena jadi 90 degree. Okay, dan sini akan jadi R. Dan what is the meaning of shortest distance? Shortest distance ini adalah distance ataupun perpendicular distance, perpendicular distance from center to tangent. Okay, sebenarnya dia adalah jarak jarak 90 degree daripada center kepada radius. Dan since center kepada tangent line kita. Dan since kita punya radius, kita punya tangent line touch kita punya circle. So that means dia automatic dia akan jadi radius. Okay, contohnya macam ni lah. Okay, contohnya kita ada satu bulat, satu garis. Okay, yang ni pun kita panggil dia sebagai shortest distance. But then, this is this line is not radius. Sebab apa bukan radius? Sebab dia tak touch. Kalau macam example yang kita ada, kalau dia touch, okay, yang ini akan jadi shortest distance. Yang ni pun sama juga jadi shortest distance. Tapi dia juga adalah radius. Okay, ini shortest, not radius. Sebab apa? Sebab dia tak touch. Tapi kalau line itu, dia touch, dia akan jadi shortest distance dan dia automatik akan jadi radius. So, that's why, bila kita nak cari radius untuk soalan ni, kita akan menggunakan formula shortest distance. Okay? So, saya padam dulu yang ini. Okay. So, saya tulis semula lah tadi. What is shortest distance? Shortest distance adalah perpendicular distance from center to straight line lah, straight line ataupun tangent lah. For our case adalah kita punya tangent. Okay, so what is the formula? R equals to modulus AH plus BK plus C over cert A square plus B square. Okay, mana nak dapat A, B dan C? Kita akan ambil A, B and C comes from kita punya equation straight line. Minus 3y minus 30 equals to 0. So, kita comparekan dengan AX plus BY plus C. So, daripada situ kita akan dapatlah. Therefore, A equals to 4, B equals to negative 3, C equals to negative 30. C yang ini dia tak ada kaitan dengan C center tu. Okay. Then, HK kita apa? HK adalah center lah. HK kita tak tahu lagi tapi kita akan masukkan value R. Sebab kita nak cari R kan? So, R equals to modulus A. So, 4R plus negative 3. So, negative 3R plus C. So, minus 30 over set A square. So, 4 square plus negative 3 square. So, from here, kita akan dapat value R kita sebagai, okay, akan ada dua lah sebab dia modulus kan. So, dia akan jadi 5R equals to modulus R minus 30. So, jangan hilangkan terus. Kita akan consider sebagai dua lah. Okay. So, ini yang kita dapat tadi. Okay, daripada sini ke sini. Equals to 5R. So, kita akan pecah satu kepada positif. Ini adalah daripada chapter first semester. Satu lagi kepada negatif 30 equals to 5R. So from here kita akan dapat positif ini, R minus 30, kita akan dapat R equals to negative 15 over 2. From here we'll get R equals to 5. Okay, tapi this one kita reject sebab R kan radius. Radius kan adalah distance. So, distance mana boleh negatif kan? So, kita akan reject this one. So, this one will be our R. R equals to 5. So, therefore, from here, kita dah dapat center. Kan center kita RR tadi kan? Center RR. So, kita terus dapat 5. So, untuk cari equation. Therefore, equation of circle is x minus h square, so x minus 5 square plus y minus 5 square equals to 5 square. Okay, soalan tak state kan nak standard ataupun general, boleh je nak biarkan dalam bentuk standard macam ni. 25, kalau rasa nak kembang, kembang je lah. Okay, so dah siap for question 13. Moving to question 14. If the line for x minus 3y plus k equals to 0 is the tangent to the circle. So, we have this one. For x minus 3y plus k equals to 0 is the tangent to the circle. X square plus y square minus 4y. And minus 2x minus 4y minus 20 equals to 0. Find the value of k. Okay. So, untuk soalan ini, kita akan buat apa ya untuk cari K. So, apa yang kita akan buat adalah kita akan menggunakan formula shortest distance. Masih lagi menggunakan formula shortest distance sebab kita ada tangent. So, kita cari dulu dia punya radius. So, first kali, find radius from kita punya GE. So, we have x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 20 equals to 0. Compare with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals to 0. So, from here we'll get g. 2g equals to negative 2. G equals to negative 1. 2f equals to negative 4. F equals to negative 2. C equals to negative 20. Okay, lepas tu, what is the formula for radius from general equation? Okay, this is the formula. Set G square plus F square minus C. So, R, masukkan je lah. 1 square plus negative 2 square minus negative 20. Okay, therefore we'll get R equals to 5. Okay, so maksudnya dekat sini, radius dekat sini adalah 5. Jadi, kita boleh gunakan formula shortest distance. Okay. Jangan saya ubah kedudukan sekejap. Ini saya ubah ke sini. Okay. Okay. Ha. Next, apa yang kita akan buat adalah daripada R yang kita ada ni, use R in formula shortest distance. Okay. So kita akan masukkan kita punya R ke dalam formula shortest distance. R equals to, ada formula dekat atas tu dalam box merah tu, over a square plus b square. Okay, so R kita 5. Then a b c kita akan dapat daripada mana? Daripada sinilah. From here kita comparekan dengan ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So kita akan dapat a equals to 4. H, do we have h? Yes. H adalah negatif g, kan? HK adalah center. So center kita, saya lupa tulis sini tadi. Center kita adalah negatif g, negatif f. So 1 2. Tahu tak? Okay, sebab negatif g, negatif f. But then this one is also HK. Ha, so masukkan je lah terus. H plus b negative 3 times k 2 plus c. So what is the value of c? K. Ha, itu yang kita nak cari, kan? Over set 4 square plus negative 3 square. Okay, so kita akan dapat, selesaikan, kita akan dapat 25 equals to modulus k minus 2. So macam tadi juga, bila ada modulus kita akan pecahkan kepada dua. Satu positif, satu lagi negatif. Equals to 25. So from here we'll get k equals to 27. So from here we'll get k equals to negative 23. Yang ini tak payah nak reject apa-apa value lah, sebab k is just a constant. Constant yang datang daripada kita punya tangent tu. Equation tangent. So tak perlu reject apa-apa. Kalau question number 13 tadi, kita reject R negative sebab R adalah radius. Okay, so done for question number 14.